Good morning, I'm Alan Johnson from Piranha Off-Road Products, and today we're playing with diff breathers. Most cars have diff breathers, and this is an example of what comes as standard on your Toyota or Nissan in many cases. What it basically is it's a one-way valve. So we'll show you how it works. What happens is the diff gets hotter and it expands, all the air expands as it gets hotter, and it can blow out this one-way valve. So we've got... So you can hear all the air hissing out the top there. Now the thing is, when you go through water or the diff cools down quickly, whatever happens, it tries to suck back and nothing. You get absolutely no air coming through here. This is a one-way valve. Now this is also the length of the one-way valve. So that's typically sitting up in here on the side of the chassis. The original one of these would have been right there on that little bracket there, which is on just below the floor of the car. Now in an aftermarket diff breather, what we try and do is make it so as the car doesn't get water into the differential and all the inside part here, which is really important. To do that, it's like a snorkel for your diff. We've run a piece of hose, which is really high quality hose, which runs all the quality up here and right up into the engine bay. On the end of it, we run an osmotic type filter, which doesn't allow water and rubbish to get in, and it keeps the air nice and clean. But really importantly, the seals on the end of this axle are oil seals, and what they're designed to do is keep the oil inside the diff. So they're a one-way seal. They're not designed to stop water from coming in. That's what it's all about. So by allowing the pressure to equalise very easily, we keep our diffs nice and clean. Now the other clever part of this is we can do more than just diffs. Come and have a look. This is your transfer box. This is your gearbox up here. Now many of these vehicles come again with a little cap, one-way valve again. We can take that cap off and we can extend that into both the transfer box and the gearbox, enabling to make this car almost indestructible to water getting into it. Unless there's an actual problem with the seals, which means oil's going to be getting out, you're not going to get water in. That can save you thousands of dollars, it can save you expensive breakdowns, and very importantly save you a heap of time. And guess what, it's also good for the environment because we're not having to change oils all the time unnecessarily. Really good things. This is a transfer box out of a Suzuki Sierra. Typically, this lives up underneath the car like you'd expect. Now, this would have had originally on a breather, just like this, sitting up the top here, a little one-way valve. We now are able to put a hose on here and run that breather right up inside the engine bay. So that's how you do a breather on a transfer box. It's as simple as putting a fitting in where the original one-way valve used to be. Now, if you've got a two-piece unit like a Sierra, you need two. If it's a one-piece unit like in many of the modern cars, you can quite often get away with just one breather. These breathers are inexpensive, typically about the $70 mark for a pair, and that can save you, as I said, thousands and thousands of dollars. Now, the things to watch out for on installation if you're doing this yourself is to make sure if you've done big suspension like Danny's done here, you allow plenty of length in the hose so the thing can fully articulate. Now, we've done ours on a hoist, which makes it really easy. Everything's just hanging as low as it's gonna hang. If you're doing it at home, I've seen a few people do this, the car sits on the ground and they don't allow enough distance. So allocate plenty of distance for that hose to go up and down without damaging. Now, if you are thinking of doing this yourself, there's a couple of traps for young players. Don't use plastic hose. Plastic hose doesn't hack it. When it gets cold, it freezes and it breaks. When it gets hot, it gets soft and it falls off. A good quality kit is going to contain the following things. It's going to contain some really good quality hose, and this hose is especially made for this job. It's an actual proper diff breather hose. It can be frozen, it can be run to very high temperatures, and it's not affected by all water, moisture, petrol, fuels, anything else. So it's going to last and it's going to do the job for you. You've got a mounting bracket, you've got your filters. These little filters can be replaced after years and years if they get dirty or contaminated. You've got your special clips that go over the hose. That joins that to that. Then you've got the full mounting kit, which is all the bits you need to hook it onto your differential. And there's actually 8 metres of hose here, which is enough to do even the biggest trucks. So you've got your hose, all your fittings and bits and pieces. Makes a complete package.